Okay, this is a video that involves leaving perfluoron in the eye. Now, this was a patient that had had surgery by one of my colleagues. I know that because I don't put draining retinotomies so close posteriorly and don't laser them so heavily. But regardless, the patient had a primary vitrectomy for a retinal detachment. You can see the patient's previously had RK, has an IOL in the eye, and had an inferior retinal detachment. And the real key is leaving perfluoron in the eye is really good for specific cases, this being one of them, a patient who has a recurrent inferior retinal detachment. And I felt like we didn't need to put another buckle on this patient's eye. I felt like we just needed to get in there and tamponade that area. And if I had seen that this retina was overly stiff, I was going to put a buckle on the eye or do a retinectomy. So once again, I'm going to start by doing a core vitrectomy all the way around to see if there's any peripheral vitreous left, then a peripheral depressed exam. And I do this pretty thoroughly. I'm going to look all the way around and see if I can find a causative break or tear. There were several suspicious areas inferiorly. The patient was still macula on. This is the area that I had the biggest question about, several ratty areas there in the inferior retina where you can see they had previous laser. And don't forget to depress all the areas, even the areas that are still attached. So here we're going to start to depress more nasally, supranasally. There you can see that posterior draining retinotomy scar. And now we're going to put perfluoron in the eye. And I've sped some of these parts up. You can see at first I start to get multiple bubbles of PFO. That's not a problem if you don't have a big break or a giant retinal tear. This patient had small breaks, so I wasn't worried about those small bubbles going under the retina and was able to unify them as I infuse the bubble in. Now, as I infuse, especially early on when I'm filling the eye with PFO, I want to be sure to turn my pressure down to 20. And I'm also not going to be infusing PFO with this dual bore cannula directly at the macula. I'm going to always be aiming away from the macula so that a jet of PFO doesn't create a break in the macula or anything such as that. Now, what I found was is that peripherally, there was still some residual subretinal fluid, even with about a 70 or 80% PFO fill. I kind of rotated the eye around to see if I could squeegee out some of that subretinal fluid. Wasn't really successful with that. So I'm going to do some anterior vitrectomy. I now have that third hand, that perfluoron in there stabilizing the retina. So I can do some additional vitrectomy, shaving down peripherally just to try to eliminate as much vitreous as possible and also seeing if I can identify any additional breaks as I shave over those areas. Now I'm going to go back in with this dual bore cannula and perfluoron, and I'm going to fill the eye up almost completely with PFO. Here we can see we get a few air bubbles and a few PFO bubbles, but those will coalesce, once again, keeping that pressure down to 20. Utilizing the dual bore cannula where we keep the outer bore in the fluid so that we're allowed to evacuate fluid from the eye so the pressure doesn't go up too much. And now we're going to start our laser in this patient's eye. We're going to start lasering inferiorly where we still find that there's some trapped subretinal fluid anteriorly. Now, in this area, which is directly inferior, I'm thinking, you know what? I'm going to leave this perfluoron in the eye so I don't have to have that area absolutely flat. I felt like that constant tamponade with perfluoron would flatten that very peripheral localized retinal detachment out, but I had some trapped fluid that was more posterior to the previous laser. And in that case, I was worried that actually this could be stiff retina. So I created a draining retinotomy, and here I go in with my soft tip on gentle aspiration under perfluoron, and I'm just going to gently aspirate. I wanted to see if that was stiff retina or if it would actually flatten under the PFO with a little bit of aspiration. It turned out it was just trapped fluid. It was not stiff retina. So I laser on my draining retinotomy. There is still some residual fluid there, but I know that's going to likely go flat under my perfluoron as I leave that PFO in for 2 weeks. This can cause some inflammation in the eye, so I put the patients on topical difluprednate drops 4 times a day. And finally, I want to be sure to have a full PFO fill. So even if I have to open another vial of PFO, it's worth it to not get an underfill. And the beauty of this is it can be sutureless. The patient can be on their back or upright for the 2 weeks while that inferior detachment heals. And then we'll go back in and remove that perfluoron 2 weeks later. Thanks so much for watching.